A very good evening and Om Shanti to all of your listeners. Welcome back to your own channel, Seek the Soul, the Truth Lies Within. And today we are here at the 262nd day of our godly blessing. And God is explaining us, or the Supreme Father is teaching us, the method of giving happiness and not receiving sorrow. So what is that? Let's see. Baba says in today's blessing, may you be a great soul who gives happiness to all souls with your elevated interactions. Now, do interactions matter? What do we interact with each other? And how that can make somebody happy or somebody unhappy? Let's find that out. All souls receive donations of happiness from every type of interaction with great souls who give happiness and receive happiness. So check in terms of being a great soul. Did I give everyone happiness throughout the day? Did I perform charitable acts? Charity means to give someone something with which that soul gives blessing. So check, do I receive blessings from all souls? Did I give or take sorrow from any soul? Now this is very, very crucial. Giving happiness could be complimenting on somebody. What do they have physically? If they've attained something, if they've earned some amount of money, if they've attained a position, if they got promoted, so you congratulate them or you compliment them upon that, and you can make them happy for a certain period of time. But there are certain things on which, if you compliment, you can make them happy forever. What are those things? And if you say certain things, could make them feel jealous, could make them feel a little down, they could come into a comparison with other souls and they could start comparing themselves or feel demotivated. If you compliment somebody, or if you show somebody else as better than them, how will that make them feel? So these are very sensitive things, very, very crucial things, which we generally, we don't pay heed to them throughout the day. And we think that we are making the other person feel motivated, but actually we put them into a competition, we put them into a certain kind of a paradigm where they're always complaining or they're always comparing themselves with others. And that is where we give them sorrow, not by realizing it, but it has become our habit that we're giving them sorrow. And we don't realize that happiness can be given to souls without having to compliment on any of the physical aspects. That's where God teaches us that you can compliment them on the qualities and the virtues. You can compliment a child, you can compliment an elderly person onto their virtues. Now, behind every good act, there's a virtue. If you compliment them on their virtue, the virtue will increase. But if you compliment them on the physical attributes can go down. But if you compliment them on the attributes which are virtues, the virtues will keep on increasing in their life. Even if they become somebody who's losing things on a financial, physical plane, still, the virtues and the values will go along with them forever. And that is what they'll remember as their strength. Whereas everything around them could be a weakness, but the strength of being happy, being content, is something which has to be thought about. When somebody does something, let's say somebody was supposed to score 100 marks and they end up scoring 70 marks. They had a chance of scoring 90. But if you make them feel content at that time, that 70 is much better than your 50s and 40s. And not the 90s which you look at. But if you're very critical on them, that's the time they'll feel sad and not happy. So every act or every word, every thought of ours can have an effect on others. Now either we are content, if we ourselves are not content, then we cannot make anybody else happy. If my hopes are very high, if my dreams are very high, not just with myself, but about somebody else, if I have got high hopes on somebody else and that person doesn't perform so well, and that's where I say, oh, I wish you could have done better. You deserve to do better. Okay, that time when that somebody has achieved something should be complimented and you can make that person happy. And yes, there is scope for progress for sure. That will come in the future too. But at that particular period of time, if I'm not happy and content with whatsoever has been attained, how can I even make somebody else content or happy? If I can make myself content, I can make somebody else also content. Now, somebody can say certain things to me. That's what God says over here. Either you are making people happy or you're making them sad, but are you also taking sorrow from other people? That's what Baba says over here. He says, do I receive blessings from all souls? Did I give or take sorrow from any soul? Give or take. Now, what is this about taking? Can we take sorrow from other souls? I have done certain things in my life. Let's say I achieved something today. You achieved something today. But that wasn't 100%. And somebody says, well, you would have done better than that. What do you do then? Do you take it as a compliment? But if you are not content with yourself, then those words of other people will pinch you. They'll feel as if they're saying that you're not good enough or you're not smart enough. What do you do then? That's where we don't need to take that sorrow. When I'm content with what I've achieved, what I've done in my life, then their comment or their compliment or any form of putting me down will not have an effect on me, because I am content. So my level of contentment also makes me feel happy, and I don't take sorrow from anything or anybody. If I feel whole within myself, not on a physical basis, I'm talking about on the basis of virtues and values, then I am somebody who is not going to get affected by anybody else's comment or anybody else's any form of putting down comment or compliment. Now, that's where God says meditation comes in. So Baba says, do I receive blessings from all souls? If I'm doing good, if I'm putting them in the right place of values and virtues, they'll feel happy with me and they'll see the good side in themselves and they'll be giving blessings. But if I show somebody their darker side, their weaknesses, I'll never receive blessings, nor will you. So then God says, only then can you be called a great soul. So never show anybody their bad side. And if somebody is trying to show you your bad side, always be in a state of contentment and self-contentment. That will protect you always. So I leave you with this beautiful vartan. If you have any experiences, if you feel that you've gone through this experience, I'm sure you've gone through this experience. But if you use this knowledge and then you experience something, and then let us know in the comment down below on this very channel of yours. That will be highly appreciated. And if you want to share this blessing with somebody else, that's also beautiful. Have a blessed day and stay safe, stay protected. Om Shanti.